Today's Morning Mass is brought to you in part by these sponsors.
Good morning. Our opening hymn is number 163, Christ the Lord is risen today. Christ the Lord is risen today. Alleluia. All on earth with angels say, joys and triumphs high, alleluia. Sing ye heavens and earth reply, alleluia. Lives again our glorious King, alleluia. Where, O death, is now thy sting, alleluia. Once he died our souls to save, alleluia. Where thy victory, O grave, alleluia. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace and peace of God our Father and the Lord Jesus be with you.
And with your spirit.
As we gather to celebrate the Eucharist this morning, we pause. We ask Jesus to forgive us our sins.
Lord Jesus, you are the Son of God and the Son of Mary. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, you are the image of God made present among us. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are the Prince of Peace and the Savior of mankind. We pray, Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, bring us to life everlasting. Glory to God, glory to God, glory to God in the highest, and on earth, peace on earth, peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory, Lord God, heavenly King, O God, almighty Father. Glory to God, glory to God, glory to God in the highest, and on earth, peace on earth, peace to people of good will. Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand, right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. Glory to God, glory to God, glory to God in the highest, and on earth, peace on earth, peace to people of good will. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most. Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Glory to God, glory to God, glory to God in the highest, and on earth, peace on earth, peace to people of good will. Amen. Amen. Let us pray. O God, who assigned St. Matthias a place in the College of Apostles, grant us through his intercession that, rejoicing in how your love has been allowed to us, we may merit to be numbered among the elect. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Peter stood up in the midst of the brothers and sisters. There was a group of about 120 persons in one place. He said, "My brothers and sisters, the scripture had to be fulfilled, which the Holy Spirit spoke beforehand through the mouth of David concerning Judas, who was the guide for those who arrested Jesus. Judas was numbered among us and was allotted a share in this ministry. For it is written in the book of Psalms, 'Let his encampment become desolate, and may no one dwell in it. And may another take his office.' Therefore, it is necessary that one of the men who accompanied us the whole time the Lord Jesus came and went among us, beginning from the baptism of John until the day on which he was taken up from us, become with us a witness to his resurrection." So they proposed to Joseph, called Barsabbas, who was also known as Justus, and Matthias. Then they prayed, "You, Lord, who know the hearts of all, show which one of these two you have chosen to take the place in this apostolic ministry from which Judas turned away to go to his own place." Then they gave lots to them, and the lot fell upon Matthias, and he was counted with the 11 apostles. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord will give him a seat with the leaders of his people.
The Lord will give him a seat with the leaders of his people.
Praise, you servants of the Lord. Praise the name of the Lord. Blessed be the name of the Lord, both now and forever.
The Lord will give him a seat with the leaders of his people.
From the rising to the setting of the sun is the name of the Lord to be praised. High above all nations is the Lord. Above the heavens is his glory.
The Lord will give him a seat with the leaders of his people.
Who is like the Lord, our God, who is enthroned on high and looks upon the heavens and the earth below?
The Lord will give his people a seat with the leaders of his people.
He raises up the lowly from the dust. From the dunghill, he lifts up the poor, to seat them with princes, with the princes of his own people.
The Lord will give him a seat with the leaders of his people. Alleluia, 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 alleluia. I chose you from the world to go and bear fruit, fruit that will last, says the Lord. Alleluia. May the Lord be in your hearts and on your lips, that you may worthily and fittingly proclaim his holy gospel. In the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "As the Father loves me, so I love you. Remain in my love. If you keep my commandments, you will remain in my love, just as I have kept the Father's commandments and remain in his love. I have told you this so that my joy might be in you, and your joy might be complete. This is my commandment, love one another as I love you. No one has greater love than this, to lay down one's life for one's friends. You are my friends if you do what I command. I no longer call you slaves, because a slave does not know what his master is doing. I have called you friends, because I have told you everything I have heard from my Father. It was not you who chose me, but I who chose you, and appointed you to go and bear fruit that will remain, so that whatever you ask the Father in my name, he may give you. This I command you, love one another." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise be to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Today we celebrate the feast of Saint Matthias. After Judas had taken his life, sometime after the resurrection, Peter called the rest of the disciples together, as we saw in the first reading today from Acts, about 120 of them, and he told them it was time to elect somebody to take the place of Judas. And they spent some time in prayer, invoking the Holy Spirit, and they chose two people, Barsabas, or Justus, and Matthias. And then they cast lots, and the lot fell on Matthias, and he became the successor of Judas. And it was important, they said, that whoever this person was, that he had to be with the Lord from the beginning, from his baptism, and witness his resurrection. So Matthias was chosen. We don't know an awful lot about him. He is the patron of people with addictions, especially alcoholics. I don't think it was because he himself had a problem, but rather that his preaching pointed out that, you know, our physical bodies are always leading us into temptation and selfishness and sin. That's just the way we are. But with the guidance of the Holy Spirit, our minds can overcome our physical desires and wants and keep them under control. And that is so true and so right. With the help of the Holy Spirit, through prayer, and using our intellect, we can control any of our desires, no matter how strong they might be. And so we can learn that from Matthias and ask him to help us always to try to live our lives accordingly, invoking the Holy Spirit to lead us and guide us. In the Gospel today, Jesus is giving his final address before he suffers and dies. And basically his message is one of love. And he tells us, greater love than this no one has, and that he laid down his life for his friends. And Jesus certainly did that for us and showed his love for it that way. Often when I read that passage, I think of soldiers giving their lives in combat to save their buddies, or firemen or policemen, or parents sometimes giving their life trying to save a child from a burning building or something like that. But overall, I think it applies to all of us. We're called every day to lay down our lives in service of others. As married people, as parents and grandparents, you're always called to lay down your life for the good of your spouse, doing things that you don't really care to do, but it's important for him or her, so you do it for them. With children, you're always putting aside what you would like to do to take care of your children and look after them and grandchildren. And so I think it's good once in a while when you examine your conscience. And I often tell this to people when they come and confess their sins. After they confess their sins, I suggest that they examine their conscience again. And sometimes I get kind of a frowning, puzzled look. I have to think even more things I did wrong. And then I say, this time, think of all the good things you do. The many acts of service and kindness you do for your family, your spouse, your children, your grandparents, out of love for other people. And very often it's nice to see a smile on their face as they begin to think of that. And I think it's good to do that because God doesn't just see our sins, but he sees our goodness too. And so often we're constantly beating ourselves up because of the things we do wrong. And we should do that. But also know that God sees all the good things we do too. And in many ways, every day we lay down a bit of our life here and there, doing things for others, when we'd really prefer to be doing something for ourselves. But know out of love for others, we do it for them. And in this way, we show our love for God too. For Jesus tells us, whatever we do, the least of our brothers and sisters, we do unto him. So reflect upon that today. Think of the many ways in which in your lifetime you have spent your life or laid down your life in service of others, your family, your neighbors, your friends, your church, your community, etc., etc. Give thanks and praise to God that you have the ability to do that. Ask him to help you, strengthened by his presence and the Holy Spirit, to continue to do so. So with that in mind, let us pray. O God, our Heavenly Father, you sent your Son Jesus to be our Savior, and he showed his love for us by dying on the cross for us. Help us to be willing in some small way to lay down our lives in loving service of others, knowing that in serving others, we're serving him. Grant us this and the favors we ask in Jesus' name.
We're our Holy Father, Pope Francis, Archbishop George Lucas, Bishop Connolly, Bishop Hannafeld, and for all the leaders of our church, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for the Lord's peace in the world, especially those places where the peace has been torn apart by war. We pray to the Lord. We pray for those who are ill, that they may experience the healing presence of the Lord. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for more vocations to the priesthood and religious life, and that we as a parish community may support those vocations. We pray to the Lord. We pray for the rain that we have received and for continued favorable weather throughout the planting and growing seasons. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for all of those who have died, that they may know the joys of eternal life. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. We offer this morning for Edward Spinner. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We also pray for Edward Wojciechowski, Phyllis Cush, Florine Marie Zuber-Schneider, and Rita Ash, all of whom died this past week or were buried this week, that they may know the joys of eternal life. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
O God, our Father in heaven, please grant us these and all our needs, for which we pray to you today, in Jesus' name. For he is Lord forever and ever. Amen. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness we have this bread to offer, which earth has given and human hands have made. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation. For your goodness we have this wine to offer, fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink. Lord God, we ask you to receive us and please with the sacrifice we offer with humble and contrite hearts. Wash away my iniquity, cleanse me of my sins. Thank you. Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Receive, O Lord, the offerings of your church, reverently presented for the feast of St. Matthias, and through them strengthen us by the power of your grace, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For you have built your church to stand firm on the apostolic foundation, to be a lasting sign of your holiness on earth, and offer all humanity your heavenly teachings. Therefore, now and for ages unending, with all the host of angels, we sing to you from all our hearts, crying out with one voice as we acclaim, Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna, hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna, hosanna in the highest. To you, therefore, most merciful Father, we make humble prayer and petition through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, that you accept and bless these gifts, these offerings, these holy and blemish sacrifices, which we offer you firstly for your holy Catholic Church. Be pleased to grant her peace, to guard, unite, and govern her throughout the whole world, together with your servant Francis, our Pope and George, our Bishop, and all those who, holding to the truth, hand on the Catholic and Apostolic faith. Remember, Lord, your servants and all who are gathered here, whose faith and devotion are known to you. For them we offer you this sacrifice of praise, or they offer for themselves and for all who are dear to them, for the redemption of their souls, the hope of health and well-being, and paying homage to you, their eternal God, living and true. In communion with those whose memory we venerate, especially the glorious ever-Virgin Mary, Mother of God and our Lord Jesus Christ, and blessed Joseph, her spouse, your blessed apostles and martyrs, Peter, Paul, and Andrew, and all the saints, we ask that through their merits and prayers in all things, we may be defended by your protecting help. Therefore, Lord, we pray, accept graciously, accept the oblation of our service and that of your whole family. Order our days in your peace and command that we be delivered from eternal damnation and count them on the flock of those you have chosen. Be pleased, O God, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and approve this offering in every respect. Make it spiritual and acceptable so that it may become for us the body and blood of your beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, he took bread in his holy and venerable hands, with eyes raised to heaven to you, O God, his almighty Father, giving you thanks and praise. He said the blessing, broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands, and once more giving you thanks, he said the blessing, gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. And therefore, Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the Blessed Passion, the resurrection from the dead, and the glorious ascension into heaven of Christ your Son, our Lord, we, your servants and your holy people, offer to your glorious majesty from the gifts you have given us this pure victim, this holy victim, this spotless victim, the holy bread of eternal life and the chalice of everlasting salvation. Be pleased to look upon these offerings with a serene and kindly countenance and to accept them as you once were pleased to accept the gifts of your servant Abel, the just, the sacrifice of Abraham, our father in faith, the offering of your high priest Melchizedek, a holy sacrifice, a spotless victim. In humble prayer, we ask, Almighty God, command that these gifts be borne by the hand of your holy angel to your altar and high, in the sight of your divine majesty, so that all of us who through this participation at the altar receive the most holy body and blood of your Son and be filled with every grace and heavenly blessing. Remember also, Lord, your servants who have gone before us marked with the sign of faith and rest in the sleep of peace. Grant them, O Lord, we pray, and all who sleep in Christ, a place of refreshment, light, and peace. To us also, your servants, with those sinners who hope in your abundant mercies, graciously grant some share in the fellowship of your apostles and martyrs, with John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, Isidore, and all your saints. Admit us, we beseech you, into their company, not weighing our merits, but granting us your pardon through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow and grant us your pardon through Christ our Lord, through whom you continue to make all these good things, O Lord. You sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them, and bestow them upon us. Through him, with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread,
and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, and by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with all of you.
And with your spirit. Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Jesus, Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Jesus, Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Jesus, Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us your peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Please join me in making a spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually to my heart. I embrace you if you're already there and deny myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. Our communion hymn is number 617. Come to the water. Oh, let all who thirst, let them come to the water, and let all who have nothing, let them come to the Lord without money, without price. Why should you pay the price except for the Lord? And let all who seek, let them come to the water. And let all who have nothing, let them come to the Lord without money, without strife. Why should you spend your life except for the Lord? Let us pray. Never cease, O Lord, we pray, to fill your family with divine gifts, that through Blessed Matthias' intercession for us, graciously admit us to share in the lot of your saints and light, through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you and grant you his peace. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God. Our final hymn is number 175, Jesus is Risen. Jesus is risen, let us sing praise to the ever-living King. Alleluia, alleluia, praise him in song, ye seraphim, praise him with joy, ye cherubim. Alleluia, 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 alleluia. this most holy day of days, let us together sing his praise. Alleluia, alleluia. Raise joyful voices to the sky. Sing out ye heavens in reply. Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
Today's morning mass is brought to you in part by these sponsors.